So hello, my name is Metwalir Hiriari and I'm a research engineer at INRAE in Angers. In this video, I will introduce you a tool to run a deep learning classification model. So this session is a hands-on to design an image classification model based on the concept of transfer learning. The objective is to show you how a deep learning model for classification is designed in practice. The Python language will be used to design our model because this language offers us an interesting tool to design our model, namely the Python TensorFlow library. You should know that designing a model on Python requires a lot of technical resources on your computer, I mean a good memory card precisely. So to get around this problem, we are going to use Google Collaboratory, a Google Cloud service that allows deep learning models to be programmed exclusively on the internet. So let's go to the notebook sheet via the Google Collab. First, you can find the notebook and the database in the compressed file in the description of this video. You must upload this document to the drive in a folder called hands-on, where I insert my notebook and my database. First of all, connect your notebook and configure it by choosing a GPU to equip your virtual environment with a better tool for processing heavy data. Let's move on to the notebook. I will give you a description of each part to the notebook. In this part, we import the tools to design our model and database. Python offers many interesting libraries for data processing and analysis. Here we import libraries for image processing and deep learning model building. We connect our drive to our notebook. Here we take the data in the compressed file. The data are images of the walls of the mouse colon. There are walls that are healthy and others that have cancer. We want to build a model that can automatically classify which images are healthy and which have cancer. After loading our tools, we can configure our data. We have a script that configures the structure of our data. We make two simples, training and test. A training simple to design our model and a test simple to evaluate the classification quality of our model. For the training phase, we form from our training sample two sets to evaluate the learning quality of our model. A training set to estimate the weight of the model and a validation set to evaluate the learning quality of the model. After determining the format of our data, we design our classification model. Here, our model is a neural network defined by four convolution layers and ending with a fully connected layer. At the end of this notebook, a softmax function assigning a probability to each class that classifies the input image. Then we define a script to determine the best model on the term of the validation loss metric. We call this best model checkpoint CNN tiny. In the configuration of the learning phase, we use the categorical cross entropy functions, which is we calculate the classification error. We use the ADOM algorithm to calculate the weights on the network, and the accuracy metric to calculate the number of classes correctly predicted by the model. And we train our model with the fit function. Based on the best model obtained in the learning phase, we can determine that the best model has 0.62 in loss and 0.73 in accuracy, which means that 73% of our data are correctly predicted by our model. From this result, we can conclude that the train model is bad. We have to think of a method to improve the quality of the model. Our approach exploits the concept of transfer learning. Essentially, it involves training an already trained model on a new database by estimating only the weights of the last layer and keeping the weights of the other layers of the network. We chose a new classification model, the VGG16. In a few words, it contains 13 convolution layers and two fully connected layers. On Keras, we have a VGG 16 model already training on the images of the ImageNet database. More precisely, there are already training weights in the VGG 16 model of Keras, and that these weights have been trained on the ImageNet database. The concept of the transfer learning consists in only estimating the weights of the last layer of the VGG16 network and keeping the weights of the other layers of the network. In other words, the concept consists in estimating only the weights on the last layer of the network. Also, the last neuron layer of the VGG16 model of Keras is only adapted of the ImageNet database. Let us specify that this last layer contains 1,000 neurons to classify the images of the ImageNet database. In our case of the colon database, we must adapt this last layer by fixing only 5 neurons to classify the images of the colon database. So here we configure the model. For the training phase, we apply the same parameter used in the training of the first model. And we can train our model by run the fit function. Based on the best model obtained in the learning phase, we can determine that the best model has 66% classification error and 81% of class correctly predicted. Comparison of the two models shows that model VGG16 with transfer learning is better than model neural net. I remind you that the purpose of this model was to show you how a deep learning model in classification is designed in practice. We have seen that the design of our of a model is structured in four parts. First, we load and configure the database. We build our model, either a model already existed in Python or some tools in TensorFlow library. We train the model, and finally, we evaluate the model. In addition to these explanations, we have also explained the concept of transfer learning, a concept commonly used in deep learning as another way to improve an already established model.